Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. I'm Jeff Knight. Please comment, like, share, subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new tutorial. Okay, this episode is going to be something a little bit different. I've never done a tutorial based on plugins. I want my tutorials to be accessible to everyone, whether you're beginning or you're advanced, or you have the money to buy expensive plugins or not. So I will never do a tutorial that requires you to buy anything. However, there are a lot of free plugins out there that you can use that will make your life a lot easier. In this episode, we'll be going over AE Juice's Copy Ease. I literally use this on a daily basis, and this plugin is 100% free. Now, AE Juice is one of my sponsors, and there's a link in the description below that you can use to go to their website and check out all the free stuff they have. They also have a lot of plugins that you can buy, and they are super cool. But we're gonna be focusing on the free plugin, Copy Ease. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so I'm on the AE Juice website, and this is a page that has a bunch of their free plugins. I'm going to focus on Copy Ease. You can download it right here, and then once you have that downloaded into your After Effects and you're open back up, you can access it. I'm going to close this out. The first time that you access it, it's going to be under your window, and you'll see right here, AE Juice, Copy Ease. I've docked my Copy Ease right here, so it looks like this. It's just a very, very simple interface, and it is extremely powerful. So I'm going to show you how this works. What I've done doesn't really matter. The thing that's important about this tutorial is the Copy Ease tool. So let's just watch this play back. Now, these are all linear keyframes. So really boring movement here. There's no easing. There's nothing special about this. And I did that on purpose because I want to show you what Copy Ease can do. Let's go to our text animation, this Jeff Knight right here. And I'm going to right click on this position keyframe, and we're going to go keyframe assistant, easy ease in. And then I'm going to do something a little complicated. Right click on this first keyframe, we'll do like an easy out, and then let's just kind of maybe play with this a little bit to give it some level of complexity, just so you can see what Copy Ease can do. Okay, so the copy and paste options you see over here, these are for copying and pasting the speed of your keyframes. So it doesn't copy the value of position or scale, it copies the speed, and that's very important and it's very powerful. So I'm going to select both of these keyframes, choose copy, and now this is my shape layer. So I'm going to highlight these keyframes here, open my graph editor so you can really see what's happening. So these are the keyframes right here for the shape layer. Now watch, when I click paste, it pastes the keyframe speed that we copied from the position of the text. Let me get back out of the graph editor. This is our text layer here. So I'm going to highlight those keyframes. And as you can see, we have this bell shape. And then if we go back and select our shape layer keyframes, we have the same shape. I am not copying the value of the position because, you know, these are coming in from two different directions. It's the speed that we're copying. Not only can you copy the speed of keyframes from like position to position, you can also copy it from position to scale. I'm going to select these keyframes right here. So this is the scale for both my text layer and my shape layer. When we click paste, it's just going to paste the last time that we copied. So I'm going to choose paste. And again, if we open up our graph editor, we can see we get that bell shape. So now if we watch this playback, it just looks a lot better. We just have something that looks more professional. Okay, so now let's focus on these keyframes here where our text and our shape scale down. I'm going to highlight all of these keyframes, and then if we go to Browse, there are some presets that AE Juice comes with. You can select any one of these and paste it to your property, whether it's position or scale. I like this Ease Out too, so it's going to kind of start slow and then go fast. So if you select Ease Out 2, choose OK. If you watch the keyframes, when I hit paste, they turn Bezier, and we can open up our graph editor, and we can see that that speed got applied. So instead of just animating in with linear kind of motion, we get something that looks a lot more interesting. And then I want to show you how to do this one more time. I'm going to focus on our text animation here. This is just going to be to animate out. As we see right now, it just kind of slides out, very boring linear keyframes. So I'm going to select these two keyframes, go back to Browse. We'll choose this Ease Out 4 right here in the bottom right, select OK. I'm going to turn on my graph editor so you can actually see this happen in real time. These are our keyframes here. I'm going to click paste, and we can see the speed value got applied. Watch it play back. We can see the effect on our text. So now we can select these keyframes, copy, and then we can highlight our keyframes on our shape layer, and paste. So you can use the presets from AE Juice, copy those speeds, and then paste them over. So the main thing to take away from this is copy ease is amazing for copying and pasting the keyframe speeds. Not the position or scale values or a rotation or anything else like that, but it's the speed. And you can copy the speed values of any sets of keyframes and paste them to anything else. So like we did earlier, I copied the speed of these position keyframes, and then we can paste them to our scale keyframes and paste over that speed. Copying and pasting the speed of these keyframes applies to anything that has keyframes, whether it's a transform property or an effect or a transition, absolutely anything. The logic of this tool is simply to copy and paste the speed of your keyframes. Now, one of the things that you can do that's related specifically to keyframes is this clone option. Okay, so I'm going to go down here to where our animation is out. I'm going to just get rid of these keyframes. And so now if I select this position keyframe, this is our last position keyframe where it animates in. Select clone, it's going to clone that keyframe and drop it wherever your playhead is. So I'm going to hit clone, and as you can see, it drops it right here. Notice it cloned it exactly. So it cloned it as an ease in keyframe. And then we can do the same thing on our shape layer. We'll leave our playhead there, select this keyframe, clone, and it drops it right there. Shift page down twice to go for 20 frames. And then let's select this first keyframe and then clone. And that's our animation out. And then select this keyframe here, this first one, and clone, and it drops it right there. The clone tool copies and pastes the keyframe and all of the properties inherent to that keyframe. So it copies and pastes the velocity that's already in the keyframe. So the clone tool doesn't assign a new velocity. It simply copies and pastes the keyframe itself and whatever velocity it happens to own. In fact, if we select these and we open up our graph editor, we can see we have these various speeds because it just copied whatever velocity happened to be on those keyframes. What we can do though is with all of these selected, go to our browse and maybe we want to select, we'll say it's ease out 3. Select OK, and I'm going to open up our graph editor so we can watch all this happen right here, and just select paste. It pastes it right onto those keyframes. Now we have that kind of animation. So this one of those plugins I highly recommend that you check out. It is extremely useful. It is something I literally use on a daily basis, not just because AE Juice is a sponsor, but because this is an amazing tool. It's something that makes life a lot easier, and I highly recommend that you check it out today and let me know what you think. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.